Hi everyone and welcome to the channel. Before we get started, please consider subscribing to my channel and possibly becoming a Patreon. Now this video is for the ReadyMaster Zuro and it's going to show you how to set up a delta wing. Now with Edge TX, we can't automatically get to the model wizards. We have to do it manually. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do it manually and launch it so that it sets up the model for you. So we're going to look at the radio first, and then I'm going to bring it up in Companion, Edge TX Companion, so you can see the settings there if you want to manually program it. So let's switch over to the radio and then we will go over to Edge TX Companion. Now let's turn our radio on.
Welcome to Edge TX.
Now there's a couple of things we need to be careful of when we are using the muzzle wizards in the Zuro, so that we don't rub one of our models out. So play it safe, back up your radio first. But what we need to do is first go into our model setting and select a model number that you want. So now we've got our model, we need to come back out, hit our system key, go across until we come across to where it says the folder is for your scripts and click. Now if we go down to wizard, the wizard folder, and click, you can now see the lure for the planes and the wizards. So if we go to delta and click and hold and we say execute, so it's going to say we've got an engine, we're just going to go page forward and we're using two channels, yes, and if we've got a rudder, we're going to say no. And then we're going to long press if we're happy with those results. Okay, now we return out. Now what that has now done is altered the new model that we made up. This is the way I found out there may be another way of doing this. So if we now edit the model and go in, you'll see when we get to our mixes, you can see our correct mixes for our two channels, our two servos that operate the aileron and elevators, and for our throttle. So that it's very simple to do. We're going to switch over to Companion so I can actually go through the settings. I won't do it here because it is set up. That would be correct. You should be good to go. So let's come back out and go across. We should see, here we go, both our ailerons and our elevators. You may have to obviously change the sense of those depending on how the servos are installed in your aeroplane. So let's switch over to Companion. Before we switch over to Companion, I just want to show you something. You've still got to do the same method that I've shown you. If we go to the model, you can see I've got to have open a model that I want it to overwrite. If I was on wing, it's going to overwrite it, so that's fine. So we started a new model, model number 15. And if we return out and go into system, go across to the SD card folders, and then go down to the scripts there and go to wizard, we can also launch the wizard that we're used to in OpenTX. So if we say wizard Lua, let's just connect, whoops-a-daisy, and execute. Now you'll see it's the way we are used to doing this. So we can now select delta and then default long press, and we should have our model. But we must remember to make sure that we have loaded a model and we're not on one that we are already using. So we should be able to check this. Go to model, go across, and we should have a delta set up there. Yep, there we go. Now let's open up the wing model. Now let's go to the inputs. So we've got the standard settings here, the AETR, the aileron, elevator, throttle, and rudder. But of course, we actually only need three. So we've got our channel one, which is going to operate one servo, which would be ailerons and elevator. And the same with our second channel. And then we've got our motor, our engine. So if we double click on the first line, you can see that the weight is split up to 50%. Now, this has to be a plus 50. And that is, so if you manually set this up, you'll take channel one and you'll set the weight at 50 and that would be it. And your source would be elevator. On your second line of channel one, Your source is going to be now, it will be aileron, input aileron, and you'll have to do a minus 50. Now this would depend on your model. You'd have to obviously make sure you check this before you fly your model that everything's working in the correct sense. Then your channel two is a reflection of channel one. So we've got weight 50% and its input is elevator. And then the second line is your weight is 50 and your input is aileron. And your motor will be exactly the same. And that is simply it. We can obviously add yaw rates in, but this video is not about that. It's about setting up a delta. I have been asked about this because there are no wizards, or at least the wizards are more difficult to get to. And in the first part of this video, I've shown you how to do that. But let's simulate it just to check everything is working as it should. Okay, let's have a look. Aileron, because I'm mode one. There you go. And elevator as well. And there we go. Okay, well, there's two ways of setting up your delta wing for your Zuro radio. Well, and I hope you found this video useful. And if you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't, give it a thumbs down. If you have any comments or questions, please leave them in the comment section below, because I'd love to hear from you. And if there's anything else I can help you with the Zuro radio, please leave it in the comment section below and I will try and help you. Thanks for watching. Happy flying. Bye for now.